This was my Christmas present. He surprised me less than a week ago. And what a dream come true. I got him this sweater. He gives me Barbra Streisand tickets.
She's my idol. It's been my dream ever since I was 6 years old and I saw Funny Girl.
I'd love to have dinner with her sometime.
Because she's more than an artist now. She's making statements about civil rights, women's rights, tolerance. It's more than just spending the money to just the pleasure of a concert.
I'm working here, but I still wish I could see it, and I know I can. So all these lucky people who are, have fun.
I don't know what the future holds for me, but she will be in my memory. It's a one-shot deal, and I'm going for it.
She had two sold-out concerts in a matter of hours. So we try to find ways to accommodate more people. And when she canceled the television cameras that were blocking the audience's view, we found we were able to pick up even more seats.
Representative. Her first public appearance, 20, 25, 27 years. This is a happening. I thought I can't miss it.
Can't think of a better way to bring in 1994. It's an event.
A lot of money now. These are $5,000 right here. It's not even a ticket.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I bought a hat, a paperweight,
and a t-shirt.
And
a
t-shirt.
Now you can't get any better than that.
20 minutes for artists. The President of the United States showing up with his bodyguards. They don't get in. They ain't got a ticket. They don't get in.
I'd like everybody to move over to the other side, please.
Are they flashing here?
Give the house lights a flash and Shelly.
I'm in front of the stage, but I need Marty's list.
Okay, then tell the orchestra to start.
10 minutes if you want to send the signal out to everybody.
Thank you.
don't know why I'm frightened. I know my way around here. The band, the lights, familiar sights, the sound here. Yes, a world to rediscover. But to stop my heart from pounding, I may need a moment. The whispered conversations in overcrowded hallways. The atmosphere as thrilling here as always. You just can't replace the feeling of the magic in the music. Why, everything's as if we never said goodbye. I've spent so many evenings just trying to resist you. I'm trembling now and thinking how I've missed you. In this ever-spinning playground, we were young together. I guess in every lifetime, you go through different stages. You grow, you learn, you try to turn new pages. But you can't replace the feeling of the magic in the music. Yes, everything's as if we never said goodbye. I've been in the wings too long. All that's in the past. Now I'm standing center stage. As if we never said goodbye. Tonight it feels as if we never said goodbye.
Last night was my opening night, tonight is my closing night. Well, it's a short run, right? I can't believe that I'm actually back here, you know? I mean, when you think of it, it's been 30 years since I was the opening act for Liberace. I remember that I designed a red velvet gown based on a choir boy's outfit with antique lace, you know? I looked so authentic, he asked me to light his candles. I said okay, but only on Friday nights, you know? 30 years, a lot has happened since then. good times and bum times, I've seen them all, and my dear, I'm still here. Gold statue sometimes, sometimes a kick in the rear, but I'm here. One day you're hailed for blazing trails, next day you're nailed for fingernails. Either they cheer or they jeer, but I'm here. I've sung in choirs, I've sung in cellars and bars, and I'm here. Clubs full of buyers, fancy saloons full of stars, and I'd hear. Don't tell me she designed those clothes, even the needy don't need those. If she won't cap her teeth, she should cap her nose, never fear. She'll disappear in a year. Hey, I'm still here. They used to say talent she's got, but those screeches sounds like her throat's in a sling. And now they say talent she's got, but those speeches, why can't she shut up and sing? Monday a Tony, Tuesday you're top of the bill, so I'm here. Wednesday you're phony, Thursday you're over the hill, but I'm here. Then comes the curse of exposés, and even worse, of overpraise. Can't let the hisses or kisses interfere. Who believes critics? I do, but I'm here. I've heard him say songwriting, acting, producing. What makes her think that she can? Or better yet, songwriting, acting, producing. What does she think? She's a man. I've been through show tunes, I've been through funk, and it stunk, but I'm here. Hit songs with no tunes, heavy duets with a hunk. Is he here? I've kept my clothes and kept my space, I've kept my nose to spite my face. Still, once you say you won't keep your place loud and clear, once you announce you're directing, all you hear is everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody says don't, it isn't right, don't, it isn't nice. Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody says don't walk on the grass, don't disturb the peace, don't skate on the ice. Well, I say do, I say walk on the grass, it was meant to feel. I say sail, tilt at the windmill, and if you fail, you fail. Everybody says no, stop, mustn't rock the boat, mustn't touch a thing. Everybody says don't, everybody says don't tell me not to live, just sit and fun. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of fun. Don't bring around a flattering on my parade. Don't tell me not to fly, I simply got to. If someone takes a spill, it's me and not you. Who told you you're allowed to rain on my parade? I didn't fake it, hat, sir. I guess I didn't make it. Ready for me, love, cause I'm a come. I simply gotta march, my heart's a drum. Don't bring around a cloud of rain on my parade. I'm gonna live and live now. Get what I want, I know how. One roll for the whole shebang. One throw that bell, we'll go clang. Shot, one gun, shot, and bam! Hey, look at me, world! Here I am! I've always loved theater songs, and this next one is from Showboat, which after 66 years is on its way back to Broadway. No plug intended. Oh, listen, sister, I love my Mr. Tell you why. There is no reason why I should love that man. It must be something that the angels have planned. Fish gotta swim, birds gotta fly. I gotta love one man till I die. Can't help loving but tell me he's lazy, oh, tell me he's slow. Tell me I'm crazy, maybe I know. Can't help loving but maybe. Tonight, huh? I needed a night to get used to this. I first heard that song when Ava Gardner sang it in the movie. I had no idea that it came from a Broadway show, you know, because I went to the movies long before I ever went to the theater. Who knew from the theater? I'd go to the Lowe's Kings in Brooklyn, right? Every Saturday afternoon, because they had the greatest Mellor Rolls. Now, for those of you who don't know, a Mellor Roll was this little ice cream log wrapped in paper that sat in this cone, you know. Anyway, I'll never forget when I was 13. Some things improve with age. A miskite, I can't believe it. Woo! This girl I knew, Barbra Sankel, you know, who knew I wanted to be an actress, she told me about this actor, Marlon Brando, who was in a movie called Guys and Dolls, which I also didn't know was from a Broadway show. So I went to see it. I came in the middle. Everybody came in the middle in those days, remember? It was a life-altering experience, seeing Marlon Brando for the first time. It was the only movie I ever sat through twice, just to get to see him again and to have another Mellor role. I'll never forget this song. When my love comes along, I'll know then and there. I'll know at the sight of his face how I care, how I care, how I care. And I'll stop and I'll stare at that face in the throne. I sat there in the theater with my hormones raging, you know, and my Mellor role melting all over me, and I felt this, I don't know, chemistry?
Yeah, chemistry. Suddenly I'll know.
Hello, gorgeous.
When my love comes along.
Is he something or what?
I'll know.
Oh my God. Here I am.
I'll know.
How I care, how I care, how I care. Who wouldn't care?
And I'll stop.
Don't stop.
And I'll stare.
You can stare.
And I'll know.
I knew from the moment I saw you.
I'll know.
Yes, I knew. In my heart.
I'll know.
Take me now and I won't ever ask.
Am I right?
Am I wise? Am I smart?
But I'll stop.
Could you faint?
And I'll stare
from that smile,
at that face,
in the throng. Oy.
Yes, I'll know.
Yes, I'll know.
When my love.
When my love.
Comes.
I was so jealous of Gene Simmons. She got to have him fall in love with her, and she got to kiss him and everything. I fell in love with you, Marlon. Right then and there, at the Lois King's Theater in Flatbush. A year later, when I was 14, I crossed the bridge into Manhattan and saw my first Broadway show, The Diary of Anne Frank. I loved it, but I couldn't afford to see many shows, so I became an usher. And I remember when I was 16, I spent New Year's Eve showing people to their seats, you know, at the Ethel Barrymore Theater. It was a great deal. I got paid $4.15 a show and got to see it for free. And then when I was 21, I actually had a show of my own called Funny Girl. And the first time I sang this song was 30 years ago. Magic number. A lot has changed since then. Music, hemlines, even the map of the world. But there's one thing that always remains constant because it's true, and it's what this song is about. People. People who need people. Needing other children.
lovers are very special people. One very special person, a feeling deep in your soul says you are half, now you're whole. No more hunger and thirst. First be a person who needs people. People who need people.
I don't know. It's all crazy. You know, I just can't believe what's happening these days, doctor.
What can't you believe, Miss Streisand?
Streisand. Everything is changing so fast, you know? What's true on Monday is not true on Tuesday. I remember my mother used to force me to eat liver because she thought it was good for me. And all those things she said were healthy turn out to be killers like sunshine, meat, milk, eggs, sex.
Now we are getting somewhere.
Alcohol is bad for you, now all of a sudden it's good for you. Butter was bad, margarine was good, now margarine is bad. In the meantime, men don't know if they should be made of iron and women don't know if they should be running with the wolves.
We seem upset today, Miss Streisand.
Streisand, soft S. And talk about relationships. I mean, since the sexual revolution, which I know will eventually turn out great, men and women don't know how to act with each other. I mean, when you go out with a man for the first time, are you supposed to automatically assume that he'll pick up the check or that you'll split it? There's so much to think about.
We sound angry, Miss Streisand.
We would sound a lot less angry if you would just pronounce my name right. You don't say Judy Garland. You don't say the Sonny and Cher show. The point is, it's all very confusing.
Streisand, Streisand, whatever. It's a very difficult name.
I wasn't talking about my name. I was talking about life.
Yeah, life.
It used to be so simple. Maybe it only seemed that way. But we knew what to eat, what to drink. You know, we knew how to be.
Why don't you just let your mind wander?
Wander?
Wander.
All right. See, I remember I was in high school. I had this blind date. And I remember sitting on the stoop waiting for him. I was wearing a long wool skirt and brown and white saddle shoes, you know. They were so hard to clean because the white polish always got on the brown part. But all I had to worry about was, will he like me when we meet? Will the shy and quiet girl he's going to see be the girl that he's imagined me to be? Girl he sees. If he doesn't, will he know enough to know that there's more to me than I may always show? Will he like me? Will he know that there's a world of love waiting to warm him? How I'm hoping that his eyes misinform him. Will he like me? Who can say? Oh, this evening seems a million years away. It's insanity to worry so all day. I'll try not to. I like your couch. We never had a couch till I was 8.
You were telling me about the time you were in summer stock.
Oh, yeah. Let's see. I was 17. I played Hortense in The Boyfriend.
Was there anything special about that summer?
Yeah, I learned how to drive a stick shift.
Did you meet anybody interesting?
Yeah, Sheila Halpern, great gal. All right. There was this boy in the company. Oh, I had a real crush on him. But he never said two words to me. And then one night he asked me to go over lines with him. and we were alone in the empty theater, and we only had one copy of the script, and so we had to sit very close to each other.
And?
He touched me. He put his hand near mine, and then he touched me. I felt a sudden tingle when he touched me. A sparkle, a glow, he knew it. It wasn't accidental, though he knew it. He smiled and seemed to tell me so all through it. He knew it, I know. He's real, and the world is alive and shining. I fear such a wonderful drive toward face the fact, he touched me, control myself, and try to act as if I remember my name, 'cause he touched me. That relationship was really quite exciting.
Do you think it was exciting because you were 17?
No. It just takes meeting the right person, I think, at any age. And when you do, a look, a touch, a late night phone call can make you feel warm all over.
When was the last time you had a late night phone
call? Last weekend. I went to this little place where they had the most incredible baked potatoes. Absolute perfection. The outside was very hard, the inside very soft.
I thought you were telling me about a man.
I was. A very, very attractive man. We talked for hours, but I couldn't concentrate on what he was saying because I was looking at his hands. His smile, his teeth, thinking. I'm in the mood for love, simply because you're near me. Funny, but when you're near me, for
I don't wanna hear your goodbye. The curtain descends, everything ends too soon. Have I ever been in therapy before? Before my last two doctors, I was into bioenergetics and biofeedback. Now I'm really fascinated by Jung. You know, the collective unconscious, the animus and the anima, the archetypal triangle, father, mother, child. It all comes down to that, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. I would think all the different types of therapy must have been very confusing.
Yeah, with all the transference and counter-transference, sometimes I don't know whether I'm the patient or the doctor.
Hello.
Who are you?
I'm Dr. Lowenstein.
What kind of a show do I have to put on for you?
What's bothering you?
I don't know.
Can you tell me anything good about your parents?
Are you crazy?
So you feel that your mother betrayed you?
Doctor, about these cigarettes.
You're changing the subject again.
Who are you? My name is Melinda.
I beg your pardon.
That's silly.
We still have a few more minutes.
What do you guys do, work on commission?
I charge $150 an hour.
Are you crazy? No, I'm normal. I swear.
I don't know what normal is.
Good. We're on the right track.
Time's up.
Did I do all right?
You can go now.
So long, Doctor.
See you later.
I understand we're here to talk about relationships.
Oh, them again.
You've just ended a long one. Is that correct?
Yeah. It was just one of those things, you know?
One of those bells?
Yeah, that now and then rings. I'm so sick of waiting for rings on fingers, on phones. I don't know how you ever make a relationship work. I mean, first of all, you have to be lucky enough to find the right person. So much has to do with timing, geography, circumstance. Then you have to be ready physically, emotionally, spiritually, and you both have to be on the same wavelength, intellectually, philosophically, politically. And if you think that just because you've got all those things in place, you're guaranteed a happy ending, not. What is this thing? This funny thing called love. Just who can solve its mystery? Why should it make a fool of me? That's why I ask the Lord in heaven above, what is this thing called love? It's amazing we can transplant and clone. We can penetrate the deepest unknown. Biogenetically, efficiently, synthetically, all
alter our genes, whatever that means. But who can explain that quirk of the brain, that place in the soul that's out of control, that part of the heart that quivers and quakes, that aches till it breaks. The tortures and thrills of heat and the chills that weaken the knees of the bites and the bees of the he's and the she's and the you's and the me's, with that internal, nocturnal, eternal, infernal disease. Oh, yes, I saw you there. One wonderful day, you took my heart. That's why I ask the Lord in heaven above, what is this thing that I keep questioning? It's so discouraging, 'cause no one's answering. What is this thing? I guess there are some questions to which there are no answers, especially those dealing with matters of the heart, particularly broken hearts. The only good thing about unrequited love is that it's been the inspiration for some of the greatest songs ever written, like this one by Harold Arlen and Ira Gershwin.
The night is bitter. The stars have lost their glitter. The winds grow colder. And suddenly you're older, and all because of the man that got away. No more his eager car, the writings on the wall, the dreams you the man that won you has run off and undone you. That great beginning has seen the final inning. Don't know what happened. It's all a crazy game. Trick of his, you're on to, but fools will be fools, and where's he gone to? The road gets rougher, it's lonelier and tougher, with hope you burn up. Tomorrow he may turn up. It's just no let up. They'll live a long night and day. Ever since this world began,
one-man woman looking for the man that got away. The man One of the nice things about growing older is that is discovering that you can survive life's disappointments. And you also realize that you can't look to someone else for your happiness. Of course, it screws up the songs you can sing. You can't sing those dependent victim songs anymore with the same conviction. For example, you can't sing, "I can be happy, I can be sad, I can be good or I can be bad. It all depends on you." No. No way. Another nice thing about growing older is that you finally begin to appreciate yourself, flaws and all. And isn't that true? This next song has taken me about 2,700 hours on various couches and about $360,000 to be able to sing. But it was worth every penny and every hour. On a clear day, rise and look around you, and you'll see. Forever and ever.
I love you too.
Memories light the corners of my mind. Misty watercolor memories of the way we were. Of the smiles we left behind, smiles we gave to one another, for the way we were. Can it be that it was all so simple then? Or has time rewritten every line? Chance to do it all again. Tell me, would we? Could we? Memories may be beautiful and yet what's too painful to remember? We simply choose to forget. So it's the laughter we will remember. Whenever we remember the way.
Gonna spoil me.
You don't bring me flowers. You don't sing me love songs. You hardly talk to me anymore. When you come through the door at the end of the day, I remember when you couldn't wait to love me. You used to hate to leave me. Now after loving me late at night, when it's good anymore. Used to be so natural to talk about forever, but used to be's don't count anymore. They just lay on the floor till we sweep them away. And baby, I remember all the things you taught me. I learned how to laugh and I learned how to cry. Well, tell you goodbye. 'Cause you don't say you need me. You don't sing me love songs. You don't bring me flowers anymore. You like my suit? You like my suit? Kaylee? Do you like my suit, really? Good. It's a variation of the one I wore at the inaugural gala, if any of you saw that. Except that one was in gray pinstripe. Now, I don't know if any of you read about this, but that outfit, not this one yet, was really attacked in my favorite newspaper, the New York Times, on my favorite page, the op-ed page. This woman writer, who shall be nameless, called it a get-up. Called this outfit a get-up that sent the wrong message.
Barbara! Now, Barbara! Don't listen to that woman!
Huh? Excuse me?
Barbara.
Who's saying that? Where are you? Can you put a light on, please? Where? Where? I can't. What? Who? Who's talking? Ah! Aren't you the lady from Coffee Talk from Saturday Night Live? Linda Richman! Linda Richman! Listen, I want to thank you because you've been very supportive to me and I really appreciate it.
Okay, whatever. Okay.
You really have.
Yes. I'm just so glad you didn't pay any attention to her and you made the same suit in white.
With beads, Taka.
Beautiful.
Well, come up on stage. I think the people would really like that. Come on. I'm serious.
Oh my God,
yeah, come on.
Don't toy with me, I'm not a plaything.
Linda, please, come on.
It's just like when Merv Griffin used to invite Mrs. Miller up from the audience. Oh my God.
It's better, it's like butter, come on.
Oh.
Come on.
Oh, I'm dying, I'm going to be on stage with Barbra Streisand. God, don't strike me dead before I get up there. Kathy Lee. Eat your heart out. Oh, my God. There she is. Look at that punam. Oh, my God. Oh. You're small. You're so little. I don't understand. I could use your leg as a toothpick.
Oh, no. You're just used to me big, 40 feet high on those screens. I'm a little person.
I can't believe with Barbra Streisand.
I can't believe that you're here.
I'm starting to get a little verklempt.
No, wait a minute, wait. Don't you get verklempt on me. Oh, great. Now I'm getting verklempt. Oh. Talk amongst yourselves. Oh. I'll give you a topic. Wait a minute. The Prince of Tides is neither about princes nor tides. Discuss. I feel better now, do you?
As do I.
Good.
By the way, I just want you to know that I canceled some very important elective surgery to be here tonight.
You look absolutely great. I love that top.
Thank you. I got a little toot step for you. But me, what about you? You look stunning.
Oh, thank you.
Doesn't she?
Oh, my God. Thank you.
Look at you. Look at you.
They do that in Queens. They do that in Brooklyn, too.
Oh, my God, girlfriend.
Yes.
Look at those legs. They're like butter. like two sticks of butter lashed together in a rough-hewn manner. And that cleavage, I tell you, it's like two tubs of beautiful whipped butter, unsalted, I might add. Look at that. I should have that cleavage. I look at you and I think I can't believe it's not butter.
Now, Linda, stop, because all this flattery is giving me spilkes in my genektikazoink, you know? So you don't think I'm sending the wrong message?
Oh, message. What's with that woman? She must be some weird meeskite, able-boodled in the cappy. How dare she write those things about you? And I quote, "This was a mixed metaphor. A woman letting us know that underneath her peekaboo power suit, underneath all her bravado and accomplishments, she is still an accessible femme fatale."
Yeah, she thought she was insulting me. I took it as a compliment. Now, is that crazy, right? I'm very impressed that you remember every word. How come?
It's stuck in my gederim like last year's gedempt. I mean, to make such a big whoop over a suit.
Suit. Oh, I love the way you do that.
Suit.
Suit. It has two syllables. Suit.
Suit. It's a diphthong.
Listen,
suit.
I'm in very good company, though. I'm in very good company.
What do you mean?
Because I don't know if you saw this, but just the other week, in the same paper, our first lady, Hillary Rodham Clinton, was accused of sending the wrong message, this is really true, for some beautiful pictures that she took in Vogue. God forbid a woman should be attractive as well as smart. Smart with two syllables.
Let me tell you.
Yes.
Let me tell you, we're all in this estrogen boat together.
I agree.
For one woman to attack another woman is shameful. Mm. For one woman to attack Barbra Streisand is a shanda for the neighbors.
You should be my agent.
Das the ligament table is able to the cup and thread.
Der Stugedaf.
Gekaken auf ein Jam.
Nebuch.
Fair poo poo poo.
Vermischt.
Verkocht.
Vertutzt.
Verstanken.
Fartig.
Exactly. 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 Listen, you have a show to do. You have
yes,
a show. Let me
I
tell
do.
You, the tickets weren't cheap. That was a beautiful dollar I spent
a
on
this. A beautiful dollar.
A beautiful dollar.
Thank you so much for coming up here. You are so adorable.
Oh, start. One last request.
What?
Can I touch you?
Where?
Nothing medical. Those hands. Oh, those hands are like butter.
Oh,
oh my God. So what kind of hand cream do you use?
Land O'Lakes.
Evidently. Now I can die.
Not before you leave the stage, please.
Oh, I can die. Oh.
Thanks for coming up.
Oh, I loved your spread in Architectural Digest. Your deco house is to die for. It's not too ungapachkin. You have excellent taste. You should be the Secretary of the Interior. I love you, Barbra. Oh, my
thank
God.
Thank you. Oh. Linda, thank you so much. God. Don't die. Oh. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, Linda Richmond. She adorable. So cute. Now I can sing again. I usually don't talk about my private life, certainly not my love life. But there is someone that I've fallen for, hook, line, and sinker. Someone who gives me great joy. Doesn't care who I am to the world, whether or not I have a good voice, or what my politics are. So you don't have to speculate, it's my 5-year-old goddaughter, Kaylee. And Kaylee is here tonight. And she has introduced me to some of the most incredible movies that I have ever seen. One of them was Alice in Wonderland. You remember that, Kaylee, at Christmas time, Daddy's house? What a brilliant film. The other one was Sleeping Beauty. I mean, these are films that I had never seen before. And I remember one day she sang this to me. I know you. I walked with you once upon a tree. And then I showed Kaylee Dumbo, and Pinocchio, two movies that I loved as a child.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are.
I said my favorite Disney song was from this movie, so I started to sing it, but she stopped me and said, that's not from Cinderella, that's from Snow White. Guess what? She was right. So this is for you, Kaylee.
Someday my prince will come.
Now this one is for my son, Jason, who's here tonight too, and last night. And I know he's old enough to take care of himself, but it's always nice to have someone looking out for you no matter how old you are, right?
Nothing's gonna harm you, not while I'm around. Nothing's gonna harm you, no sir, not while I'm around. Demons are prowling everywhere nowadays. I'll send them howling, I don't care, I've got ways. No one's gonna harm you. Can desert you, not to worry, whistle, I'll be there. Demons will charm you with a smile for a while.
loose and being clever ain't like being true. I don't need to, I would never hide a thing from you like some. No one's gonna hurt you, no one's gonna dare. Others can desert you, not to worry, whistle, I'll be there. Our demons will charm you with a smile for a while, but in time, nothing can harm you. No. What's better than children? I believe that the most powerful source of energy is the human heart. It's capable of deep compassion and caring. And when someone acts out of that compassion and caring, something in the world changes. A volunteer in a homeless shelter or an AIDS hospice, a reader to the blind. They may not make the history books or even the 6 o'clock news, but in their quiet way, they help repair the broken pieces of the world. Change can come on tiptoe. Love is where it starts. It resides, often hides, deep within our hearts. Said just as pebbles make a mountain, raindrops make a sea. One day at a time, change begins with you and me. Ordinary miracles happen all around, just by
love is all.
necessary. Love in its extraordinary way. Extraordinary miracles every day. Beautiful, I love it too. 30 years ago, the rehearsal pianist for Funny Girl was a young musician named Marvin Hamlisch. They know you, Marvin, they know you. He has come a long way since then, winning 3 Academy Awards, 4 Grammys, a Tony, and the Pulitzer Prize for a chorus line, so he doesn't need this job. He also wrote the music to that beautiful song, Ordinary Miracles, along with my dear friends, Marilyn and Alan Bergman. And I'm so very happy to have him with me tonight. Please help me thank my musical conductor, arranger, friend, wonderful person, Marvin Hamlisch. I'm gonna miss you. Is the sweetest thing. And at the other end of his baton is a really wonderful all-star orchestra from Los Angeles. I'd like them to stand up. I hope you can see them because they are magnificent. Thank you so much. You know how much I appreciate you. It's been a joy. Thank you. Do you have any idea what a thrill it is to sing with these superb musicians behind me? As an easy chair, love, fresh as the morning. It's my own song, I can't believe it. Whoa, love that is shared by two. Like a rose under the April snow. Remember, Johnny? I was always certain love would grow. And Elliot behind him, I think this is adorable. Love, ageless and evergreen, seldom seen by two. You and I will make each night a first, every day a beginning. Spirits rise and the dance is unrehearsed. Lights that shine as one, morning glory and the midnight sun. Time we've learned to celebrate. Time won't change the meaning of
ageless and ever.
Nice. This is going to be nice to remember. The list of talented and gifted people, really superb people in my profession tonight, is so impressive and so long, and I don't want to embarrass them. I couldn't possibly acknowledge them all, but you know who you are. And I decided that I would limit my introduction to two very special mothers. First of all, a woman without whom I would be nothing, literally. My mother, Diana Kind, Diana Streisand Kind. Don't sing, Ma, though, but where are you? Okay. There's my mommy. You look very pretty, Mom. Thank you. My mother, like me, was always afraid of flying. You can sit down now, Ma. She'll stay there forever. And she actually got on a plane to come here, and I'm very proud of you for that, I think. You see, you're never too old to grow. Since the death of her husband, the great Martin Luther King Jr., this woman has walked his dream every day. It is my privilege to introduce Coretta Scott King. Hi, Coretta. So happy you're here. Thank you. Thank you, too. Thank you for coming. And there is also a woman here tonight who I'm crazy about. She is a person whom I admire for herself in her own right. Ladies and gentlemen, the woman from whom the President of the United States inherited his tenacity, his compassion, his optimism, his mother, Virginia Clinton Kelly. Well, this is the start of a new year, and there is a new spirit, a new hope sweeping the country. You feel it? It's a chance for new beginnings, a chance to heal old wounds, and to reach out to one another. Of course, there will be setbacks along the way, but in the meantime, we have a lot to celebrate. To be living in this great country of ours in these exciting and changing times. Happy days I hear again. The skies above are clear again. So let's sing a song of cheer again. Happy days are here again. All together, shout it now. There's no one who can doubt it now. So let's tell the world about it now. Your
dead. So let's sing a song of cheer again. Happy times, happy nights, happy days are here
Now, I'd like to sing a song for you that I haven't sung in 22 years. We were talking about it before I went on. 22 years. Oh, my man, I love him so. You'll never know. All my life is just despair, but I don't care when he takes me in his arms. The world is bright, all right. What's the difference if I say I'll go away when I know I'll come back on my knees someday? For whatever my man is, I am his forevermore. It cost me a lot, but there's one thing that I've got. It's my man. Cold and wet, tired, you bet, but all that I soon forget with my man. He's not much for looks, and no hero out of books. He's my man. Two or three girls has he that he likes as well as me, but I love him. Oh, my man, I love him so. He'll never know. Oh, my life is just despair, but I don't care when he takes me in his arms. The world is bright, oh, alright. What's the difference if I say I will go away when I know I'll come back? Whatever my man is, I am here forever. Don't get up! Don't get up! It's okay! It's all right! I don't want you to get tired! Whoa! You are something! What's your name?
Leah.
Leah, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
That's very sweet of you. Are you going to be okay going back down? You want me to help you? Let me help you because I don't want you to fall. so sweet. Now, don't push me. Remind me to take those. Now you're going to get me all verklempt again. All right. Talk amongst yourselves. I'm going to give you a topic. Mao Zedong's Cultural Revolution was neither cultural nor a revolution. Discuss. See, I can replace Linda Richman now, right? Thank you. This has been... You know, is this the audience participation part? Is that what this is? What is that noise? Whoa! Thunder! This has been a very, very special night for me. I have a lot of dear friends here. And in just a couple of hours, I feel I've made some new ones. We've come together from all over the country, the world, who knows. But before we leave each other, I would like to thank you so much for coming and sharing this adventure with me. I'm grateful for the love and support that you've shown me tonight and for all the years past. I think I even enjoyed myself. I did enjoy myself tonight, I have to admit that. Last night I didn't enjoy myself. Tonight I enjoyed myself. Isn't that right? Did we have fun tonight? Woo-hoo! This was fun, this was fun. Gotta admit it. I guess this song sums up the way I feel. For all we know, we may never meet again. Oh. Before you go, make this moment sweet. We won't say goodnight until the last minute. I will hold out my hand, and my heart will be in it. This may only be a dream. We come and we go, like a ripple on a stream. So love me tonight. Tomorrow was made for some. Tomorrow may never come. For all we know. Well, today is the first day of the new year, and I want to wish you happiness all the days of the new year. And I know you join me in hoping it brings us closer to a kinder and more peaceful world. So take care of yourselves and each other. I'm so glad our paths have crossed. Goodbye for tonight. Remember it now and then.
there's no telling where or when. For all we know,
it's extraordinary. Thank you.